Hi everyone, so in this video I'll be showing you our taxi booking platform. So I'll show the customer application as well as the driver application, and I'll show how the customer can place a booking and the driver will receive it and the driver will complete the booking. So this is the customer application. So the customer can see the map and he can see his location, and the customer can select that where he wants to go. So the application has auto detected the pickup location. So this is the pickup location, and the customer can change it as well. And the customer then has to enter that where he has to go. He can enter the location manually, or he can pick up the location from the saved recent locations. So I'll just select this location, and he can select that this is the pickup or the drop off location. So I'll just select drop off address and then click on done. So the complete map is shown and the direction from where the customer would be taken to his destination. So the customer can select the vehicle type now. He can see that there are various vehicle types. So, and he can also see that the estimate time is 1 minute, and I'll just select the taxi and click on proceed. So the customer can see the estimated fare now, and he can see the seating capacity also, right? So I'll just select mini and click on book now. And now the customer can select that he wants to pay cash or he wants to pay online. He can change the option from here. Also, there's a wallet integrated in the customer application, so he can pay through the credits also. Also, there's an option where he can apply a promo code to get some discounts, and he can set that up from the admin panel. So here he can see the seating capacity and the estimated fare, that is 174.44. And here are the pricing details, the fare breakdown, that what is the base fare, the per minute charge or the per kilometer charge. So now I'll just make the booking. Here there's another screen to confirm the pickup location. So I'll just select confirm pickup. So now there are push notifications, and as you can see, the nearby driver has got the request. So he can just see the complete pickup location, and he can see the drop-off location, and now he can slide right to accept, or he can slide left to reject the booking. So I'll just accept the booking. So the booking has been accepted, and so I'm at the same location right now, so I can just click on arrive and I can just start the service. And the driver would be redirected to Google Maps, where he can see the complete directions, that where he has to go, where he has to drop off the customer. So this is the complete location. And on the customer application, you can see that the customer can see the complete driver details. Also, he can cancel the ride, he can call the driver at any point of time. And also on the top right corner, we have a panic button. In case of emergency, the customer can press it. So when the drop-off location is reached, so the driver can just click on end service, or if there's a halfway stop, the driver can add that. And if there's a breakdown, so the driver can just click on breakdown, and another booking would be made, and the next nearby driver would get the booking. So I'll just end the service, and there's a confirmation. So when the driver clicks on yes, so the booking is complete, and now he gets the checkout page that the amount to be collected is this much rupees, and he also gets the bifurcation that the base fare was this, and the waiting charges, the distance covered, the normal fare, booking fee, everything he can see it from here. And when he receives the money, he can click on complete service. So now the driver can rate the customer, and he can write some comments also, and or he can just skip it and click on submit. And now moving forward to the customer application. So the customer can also see the same details, that how much amount he has to pay and what is the bifurcation, and he can see the complete invoice and then click on finish, and then he can rate the service of the driver, and I'll give this, and he can also add comments and click on submit. So there are push notifications at each point of time. So this is the complete customer interface and the driver interface. So I'll just show you some of the features that we have in the customer application. So the customer can see his details, his customer ID, his profile picture. He can see all the past bookings, he can check it from here, or all the upcoming booking if he has scheduled a booking, so he can check it from here. So the next option is notifications. He can see all the push notifications. So push notifications are saved and he can see at any point of time. Next is the travel packages. So if he wants to opt for any travel package, for example hourly package or daily package, so these can be set up from the admin panel and the customer can choose any of the package and see its details, and he can just place a request from here. Also he can see all the terms and conditions from here. Next is the emergency contact. So I showed you earlier that there's a panic button on the top. So if he clicks on panic button, he'll be redirected and a call would be placed on these numbers. By clicking on the emergency contacts, from here also the call can be placed and the customer can set up his emergency contact from this option. So if I click on this, so it will be redirected to the caller ID section. So the next is the settings. So the customer can select that he wants push notifications or not. He can see the terms and conditions, he can change the language, and he can see the privacy and about us section. And next is the help section. So the customer can reach you at any point of time. He can reach via phone or email, or he can register a complaint and send a message to the admin. So I'll just show you the driver application also. If the driver picks up a customer from road, he can just onboard him on the platform by road pickup. And then there's the home option. From here he can see the map and he can see where he is currently. Then he can see the bookings, all his past bookings or the upcoming bookings. He can also check it from here. Then we have the notifications. He can also check all the push notifications from here. Then he can make a travel package for himself by calling the admin. He can create a travel package. Then he can check all of the earnings from here. He can see that how much money he has made by working for your platform. Then he has the same settings as the customer, so he can just turn on push notifications. He can see the terms and conditions, he can change the language. Then he can also contact the admin using these options. So this is it from the customer application and the driver application. In the next video, I'll show you the admin panel. Thank you.